Today, I thought we could watch some UFO videos. I stumbled across some footage that looked really interesting, piqued my curiosity, and I found it really hard not to believe that it was like legit footage. But who knows? After the release of that AAR report, several months back now, the government state that any sort of UFO sighting is them testing out their machinery, weaponry. They are 100% refuting that there is any extraterrestrials gracing our skies. We aren't under any alien sort of surveillance or anything like that at all. But let's just go along with it, shall we? So let's watch this first video and see what it's all about. Wow, that looks awesome. I mean, it looks pretty convincing. It looks pretty insane and unreal and like exactly what anyone watching a video wants to see. But I don't see any shadows being cast by any of this flying saucers. I don't know. It looks too good to be true, so. It probably is too good to be true. Or it's just the government. Like they want us to believe, testing their machinery.
This is a recent trending video of a possible short 3 to 4 foot extraterrestrial gray being that was filmed at a home security camera reportedly captured on March 29th, 2024 from the Skinwalker Ranch. Now, this image is one of the clearest ones I've seen thus far of one of these beings. Take a look at this quick video clip and image and let me know your thoughts and comment below.
Dude, that was incredible. Did you see that? Is some sort of upright being. When it zooms in on the alien, I'm not sure if that is the actual image right there. But wow, it's on Skinwalker Ranch where like the weirdest stuff happens, isn't it? It's like the hotspot for all types of paranormal activity and alien sightings, UFO sightings. Yeah, of course it's going to be blurry and shaky. Yeah, but it's apparently from the energy that comes off their bodies and also them trying to cloak themselves. That's what the creator said in the comment section anyway. I don't know how believable that is. Like, how do you know? Just someone physically go out there and measure the energy waves and frequencies and things like that. I don't know. Like everything is so speculative. I just can't say for sure. But hey, that one was really, really cool.
Have you seen this recent UFO sighting that's starting to go viral? The object was spotted over a city in Brazil on July 7th, 2024. It was seen in broad daylight, and if you watch closely, you'll see it morph, expanding and contracting. Was this a non-human intelligence craft? What do you think it was?
I don't know if that one's real or not. It feels like they added in like background noise. The creator who posted this content pretty much believes the authenticity of this sighting, this video, from what I can see on TikTok. People are saying it looks like a tent. Hey, it's an unusual shape. Like, it's not a shape that I'm familiar with seeing or like that is notable when you think of UFOs. But yeah, it could definitely be a Project Bluebeam moment. I'm not too sure. Let me know what you guys think of that one. But yeah, I mean, we can always say like, oh, it could be the government now, because That's what they want us to think. It's them. Then if they're making these kinds of craft, can we all have one so that we can, you know, zip around the world like so fast? Because cars are so slow and stupid. Apparently it's real. Apparently it's from Brazil and it was spotted only in July of this year. So literally nearly 4 weeks ago. The difference between this video and the previous video is that the person filming it, you could tell that they were filming it from inside the airplane. I probably should have picked up on this in the first one, but I didn't. I was just so mesmerized by the clarity of the image. Oh my goodness, I'm so like gullible. Apologies for my lack of pickup on that one. But in this one, you could see that someone was clearly filming it from inside the airplane, and it looked like one of those small, tiny planes, not a commercial plane at all. And the windows were dirty, and you could see the glare and the reflection of the glass, grime on the actual glass. So that was a bit more believable. This next video looks interesting only because the person speaking about aliens and alien disclosure is the former Secretary of Defense, Paul Hellyer.
Had in fact been face-to-face meetings between United States officials and extraterrestrials from other star systems. Have reports of several species that are here and have bases here. There's one species that looks something like a praying mantis. And then the short grays are the ones that you see in the cartoons. The tall grays look much different. They look more like humans. And the Nordic blondes, for example, are so similar to humans that they can walk down the street and not be detected. They are way ahead of us in medicine, agriculture, and still, I guess, presumably in technology. They know something we don't know, and that is every atomic bomb that is put off on Earth has an effect on other parts of the cosmos. They were concerned about it.
There's always something like grounding when you hear the testimony of someone who was a very respectable someone in government, no less. These people that come forward, I believe anyway, are allowed to say these things. And I feel they say these things for some type of reason. So yeah, it's kind of a double-edged sword, isn't it? Like someone respectable with authority comes forward and says, oh, there's like mantis beings, there's grays and nords, and they're all advanced and they're finally telling us something. But then the Americans contradict that with that AARO report, which refutes any extraterrestrial life forms and activity in the skies. It's gotta make you wonder, what is the agenda here? What are they hiding?
Strange UFO sighting in the skies of Hudson Square, New York. As I was flying home from Myrtle Beach capturing videos of the city, I noticed a shadow came out of nowhere. Pay attention or you'll miss it. Comment what you think that is.
Oh my gosh. These videos are like kind of frustrating. I mean, I like that it's a new one. This is brand new. The sighting was in March of this year, so it's relatively recent. But I don't know if it's real or not. How the hell do you tell? Like, you'd think that an article may have been written about it. There's just so many sightings that it's hard to tell whether they're legit or not anymore. What do you think makes a sighting legitimate? I love those Redditors out there that, you know, create software programs to calculate certain things and speeds just by the video image going by or whatever. Oh, I don't know. I mean, seriously, is everyone like looking out their window when they're on a plane with their iPhones in anticipation of seeing a UFO? All right, I have time for one more video. This one is a UFO sighting in Ontario, Canada on July the 8th, 2024, which is also a very, very recent sighting. It is like a speck, but a shiny, it's a shiny speckle. I don't know what that is. How would anyone know what that is? Okay, so someone in the comments says that they saw this over Seal Beach Navy Weapons Station 1 week ago, but it stayed in place for a couple of hours, then it just disappeared. It was up so high and it looked like a pole with a red light on the bottom. I think they meant it looked like a pole, maybe. That's sort of interesting. They said they tried to take photos but couldn't get a clear one. Like, I don't think anyone ever can get a clear photo, can they? And then he says his phone, when he tried to take a photo of it, went into some kind of error reading. That's kind of interesting, but I don't know. I think if you stare at the sky for long enough these days that you can kind of like, you know, think you've seen something, or that the stars are moving or there's a light moving. I don't know, but it's definitely unusual. It doesn't look like what you would typically see in the daylight. It's definitely a UFO in terms of what it plainly represents. It's an unidentified flying object. There's no way anyone could identify that. At least not a regular person who doesn't work for the government. Anyway, let me know what you thought about that. That's all I have for today. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye.